How to play track number 17 on 1990's official soundtrack to The Godfather Part III, Coda, The Godfather Finale. This was originally composed by Nino Rota and arranged and conducted by Carmine Coppola in this version. And what he's done here for this closing track is a very similar orchestration to the first score's closing track, The Godfather Finale, and the second score's closing track, and title. It's just that this one is going to be completely omitting any other themes and solely focus on Rota's The Godfather Waltz, which it is based on. We will be transposing from the string section, being led by a violin, and the brass section, as well as look at what the mandolin is playing towards the end of the song. Then there's also chimes and a harp accompanying, but in order to learn how to play this, we begin with a tuning which is standard G, D, A, E. The track is opened by the violin, and I'm going to be demonstrating each segment before slowing it down to show you how to play it. We begin this on the 8th fret of the E string, 7th, 8th, 9th, 8th fret twice, 11th fret A. Back to the 8th fret on the E, and then repeat the 7th, 8th, 9th, and the 8th fret twice, and then instead go to the 10th fret on the A. Back to the 8th fret E, 7th, 8th, 11th, 8, 7, 10, 8, 11th fret A, 10, 11, 8th fret E, 7, 10th fret A, 10th fret A again, 12, 7th fret E, 8th, 10th, play the 10th again to slide it up to the 11th, after a slight pause, slide the 10th fret up to the 11th once more, 10th, 8th, 7th, after a pause slide it up to the 8th, pluck that again. Now let's play through these bars slowly. The next segment has the brass and string sections playing together, and we could be playing this in one of two octaves. I'll be demonstrating both the low and the high one. We'll be beginning with the low one. Which we begin by sliding the 4th fret of the A down to the 3rd, then playing the 2nd, and then the 3rd frets, repeating, once more repeating, before moving up to the 4th fret, 3rd, first, 6th fret D, 5th, 3rd, 2nd, just slight pause, 3rd, 5th, and 5th again. The second octave is simultaneously going to be playing the exact same melody. Beginning by sliding the 9th fret of the E down to the 8th, 7th, 8th, repeat this. Repeat this once more. 9th, 8th, 6th, 11th fret A, 10th, 8th, 7th, 8th, 10th, 10 again. And towards the end of the segment, there's actually a second voice playing another melody. As the lower octave plays, and the higher octave plays, doing this first G, is where the second voice comes in, beginning on the 5th fret of the G, 4th, 5th, 6th, 5th, 3rd. The segment continues in the lower octave. Which will again begin by repeating. Before moving up to the 6th fret, 5th, 3rd, 1st, open, 5th fret D, 4th, and 5th fret twice. The high octave continuing, also again beginning by repeating. Before moving up to the 11th fret, 10th, 8th, 6th, 5th, 3rd, 2nd, and the 3rd fret twice. The next segment, again being something we could play in two octaves. beginning by hitting the open A string and hammering it onto the first fret, and then slowly sliding it up each fret until we reach the 8th. Pluck for 7th, 8th, 9th, the 8th fret twice, and the 11th fret on the D. Then we're back to the 8th fret on the A, repeating. But this time ending on the 10th fret of the D instead. The high octave, simultaneously playing the same thing again. With this beginning by hitting the 5th fret on the E, and slowly sliding it up each fret until we reach the 13th. Then we pluck for 12th, 13th, 14th. 13th twice, and 16th fret A. Then go back to the 13th fret on the E, repeating. But this time ending on the 15th fret of the A. Now we should be at 1 minute 41 seconds, and this is where the mandolin finally comes in. It will be playing with a continuous tremolo. If you're not yet familiar with what that is, all that means is rapid alternating down and up picking. If you're familiar with the trilogy score, you will notice that this piece is played at a slower pace than the previous iterations. We begin on the 8th fret of the A, 7th, 8th, 11th, 8th, 7th, 10th, 8th. Hold it and slide it down to the 4th fret, 3rd, 4th, 1st fret E, open, 3rd fret A, hold it, 3rd fret again, 5th, open E, 1st fret, 3rd, 4th, hold it, 4th again, 3rd, 1st, open, 1st, and hold this until the song fades out. Thank you. Simultaneously, as the mandolin is playing this tremolo, there are the reed instruments in the background playing something nearly identical. So we'll be repeating this minus the tremolo, starting on the 8th fret of the A, 7, 8, 11, 8, 7, 10, 8, 4th, 3rd, 4th, 1st fret E, open, and now instead of going down to the 3rd fret of the A, we're going down to the 5th fret of the D, followed by the 3rd. Then we're back to repeating 3rd fret A, 5th, open E, 1st fret, 3rd, 4th, 4th again, 3rd, 1st, open, 1st. So you can see that the way I've split this up is for the mandolin part to play with tremolo, as it does on the recording, and for the rest, transposed from the other instruments, to play as plucked notes. Ultimately, it's up to the player whether they would like to do so, or maybe play with a continuous tremolo throughout. Or maybe use tremolo only selectively to sustain some notes.